This is a BK Precision 1711 DC power supply. I picked this up on eBay. It actually indicated that it was working. And maybe it was when it left them, but now it doesn't. I plugged this in briefly and got absolutely nothing. It's a very clean unit. Don't see any obvious signs of any kind of abuse. No magic smoke smells. So today we're going to take this apart and see if we can see what's causing it not to turn on. Okay, I've got the unit turned up on its side. I don't see any obvious issues. It looks like that at one point there may have been a little bit of moisture that's been in here, but it's not too bad. I don't see any obvious issues, so we'll need to dig a little further to see what may be occurring. I'll just give you a quick peek. Relatively simple design. Okay, generally one of the first areas you want to check on any device. I don't really recommend, if you find a bad fuse, there's something wrong. Something else has happened. And if you do find something like that, you need to really look ahead of what may have caused it to happen. On this particular unit, the fuse looks perfectly fine. We'll check it here with a ohm meter just to verify. But that doesn't appear to be what the problem is. And no, the fuse is not the issue. This fuse is perfectly fine. Like I say, it's one of the easiest things to check, but also if the fuse is blown, something's caused that to happen, and you should really check to make sure what the actual issue is, what has caused the fuse to blow to begin with, before proceeding. Okay. We've got the unit plugged into the main power. Obviously the fuse was not bad. So we're just going to check a couple of key points. Just determine what's wrong with this. One of the areas, if you can see, will be this here. This is a fuse holder, and this is where the power enters the unit. On the back side, there's primary and secondary connections. The ground and neutral side, the 120 volt side, is very easy to distinguish. And the other output side comes right up to here, going along these larger traces. And we're just going to check there to see if there's any voltage at all. And there's no voltage. So we either have a bad transformer or the transformer itself is not being powered. So I'm just going to check around this side. It would appear the problem is actually somewhere in between the fuse area, the cable, the cord itself. So this is more than likely not going to be an electrical problem. This is going to be, or is an electrical problem. More than likely, this is going to be an issue of the AC input into the transformer. Now that could be the cord. We've already checked the fuse, but there could be some connectivity issues. The quickest way to check that is to actually do a continuity test to see where the failure is occurring. And we're going to do that now. Okay, we're going to do a quick continuity test to see if this is actually working or not. And the first thing I want to verify is that we don't have anything strange going on. Shorts against the cord. It appears we're okay. Okay, it's a little bit strange. Basically what I'm seeing is the ground prong from this plug actually goes up and it connects directly to this chassis. There's actually a screw, blind headed screw that this actually, that ground wire directly connects to. And we're getting a bit of resistance. It's about 1 ohm. Which is strange. It may mean there's not very good connectivity. Also, I'm noticing when I move this cable, it actually changes. So what I'm very suspect of, and I'm actually not getting a connection at all. On the hot or the neutral. Of this. So what that's telling me is somewhere along this cable, I visually inspected it. The only real area I can't see is where it goes into the chassis here. It does feel a little slack there. I'm almost positive that there's the issue is like right between here. And it's lucky that I caught it now. That could have been a potential hazard to actually have that broke at that particular point. It could have contacted this chassis. That split bushing doesn't, I mean, there's a lot of gaps in the split bushing, and it could have come in contact with something and possibly energized the chassis, especially with this ground connection not all that great. So I'm going to swap that out real quick and we'll see what happens. Okay, I've swapped that cable out. I've verified with my ohmmeter that we have good connectivity now from all the way from the plug to the back into the fuse holder. The transformer is being powered and there is output on the transformer. Everything looks normal. I'm just going to give it a test fire here to see if see what we have. Okay. We're actually getting voltage. I'm going to set this at about 20 volts. I hear relays clicking as I inch up. That's set at 20. And I'm going to set the current just at a bit and we'll see what we have here. Okay, the meter's reading 20 and I'm seeing 20.556. at the meter. Okay, here's the 71011. The device is running. There is a little bit of vibration back here, which I plan on tape pulling some of this back apart to fix. This heatsink's fairly loose. But this is powering one of the radios that I designed, VHF 12 volt supply. And it supplies it just fine, and all the current controls are really nice. I don't have a lot of analog type equipment with analog displays, but it's kind of nice. It goes to a little bit higher level of voltage than what many of my other supplies do. It'll be a nice addition to the lab. One thing I've noticed now that we've got the unit working, there's a bit of vibration. It's very annoying. You can hear it especially when it first turns on. But this heatsink assembly is just held in place by these tabs. There is a locking mechanism which goes across this, which prevents the heatsink assembly from, you know, leaving the power supply. However, it doesn't prevent this heatsink assembly from moving around. Now, I've already made some adjustments, and basically what that entails is just bend these tabs in where they're very, very tight, where you basically have to pull these tabs out just a bit to get the heat sink down. I'm assuming that's the way that it came from the factory, nice and tight, because it was very, very loose when I got the unit. And hopefully this will fix the annoying noise problem.